Ousmane.
Bonjour, Anan.
Comment ça va? Bien?
Ça va très bien.
Très bien.
Et toi, Monsieur Robert?
Which accent is that?
That's a French accent.
Non, he's speaking good.
Non, je parle français bien.
Uh-huh.
Oui.
A lot of improvements.
Yeah. And this is 2017,
like
so we have to start well.
No, I don't speak French.
It's 2017, we have to start well, and I want to welcome our audience, those who love science and technology, to 2017. I hope you had a great year, and I hope you had a great year too, Robert and Anan.
2016
yeah.
was a good year.
Yeah.
I can't complain. If you go on complaining about everything, you will have nothing to say something positive about. So keep your head up.
Well, it was great for technology as well, mm-hmm. because there were more revelations and more releases were made just at the end of 2016. It was revealed last week that American e-commerce company Amazon had been awarded a patent since May for a giant flying warehouse. If you don't believe it, well, they patented it and they are looking forward to having that. A flying warehouse.
Wow. I don't understand.
What's flying?
It's going to have a lot of goods and services which will be delivered. So they are saying that it's going to serve as a launch pad for drones to deliver items. This warehouse, which they call Airborne Fulfillment Centers, will look like an airship stocked with lots of products at an altitude of 45,000 feet. According to the leaked patent, the airship will remain in the air and be refueled and restocked using a smaller aircraft. The aircraft will also shuttle workers to and from the airship. Soon, when a customer places an order, a drone will fly from the airship and deliver the package, just like a sci-fi movie. But this is possible because already Amazon has successfully made its first drone delivery last month using its Prime Air services. So this is possible because they are ready for it and they are preparing and they are doing other things, other tests see if they can do this.
I feel like Amazon has done a lot of, there's many innovations coming from the company. Beaucoup d'innovations de la part d'Amazon. Oui. They did this thing called Amazon Go.
Yeah.
Amazon Go, which is about you go to a supermarket and you just grab everything you want without paying, going through the cashier.
Wow.
Sans passer par la caisse.
Well, from where they're going with this, I think we'll start living in the air very soon. I'm going to my house.
I hope there'll be no collisions.
No, I think they'll be stationary.
Yeah.
Even from the sci-fi movies I've watched, where people are living like in space, just stationary at one point. I'm flying home.
I can't wait for that time when I can just click a button and then my shoes would lift me up in the sky.
It's already, happening.
It's already happening. Well, now let's move to some Twitter news, because last week Twitter announced that 360 videos can now be viewed in Periscope right on the Twitter stream. Using an Insta360 camera that is attached to a smartphone, you can shoot 360 videos. When the video is 360 enabled, you will see a red live 360 tag on the video. This is still in the early stages, so you might experience some problems if you have it. Note that without an Insta360 camera, you can't take a 360 video on Twitter. In case you don't know, a 360 degree video are video recordings that shoot every direction at the same time. The viewer can choose to watch any angle of the video during playback. 360 videos are quite interesting. We tried one in the studio some other time, but they are very delicate because if you don't have a bigger space and also a lot of objects around and the camera not being stationary, it's very difficult to get a 360 video.
Wow. Yeah. Well, I think that's it's a good development, but it's not going to help bring world peace though. They should try something.
It can bring world peace, and it's going to help journalists especially, because now people want to see the whole angle. So you can use your phone and your Insta camera to shoot a 360 video, and it's going to be good. It's going to be very good. Already everyone is going live, and African News is live as well.
I've seen that happen.
Yes. Well, now that we are in 2017, we should expect a few court actions. Already, Nokia has filed a number of lawsuits in several locations against Apple for violating 32 technology patents. The patents in question include displays, user interfaces, software, antennas, chipsets with or end video coding. Apple also took legal action against two other companies, accusing them of colluding with Nokia to extract and extort unfair revenues from them. Both companies sued each other back in 2009 and eventually settled on a 2011 agreement, which Apple is accused of breaching. The lawsuit wars have begun and monies will go back and forth. We hope this does not affect our technology. As it is said in Africa, when two elephants are fighting, it is the grass that suffers. Absolutely. And I hope we don't suffer.
Absolutely.
But this happens often.
Of course it does. But one company is notorious for when they're settling their lawsuits, they deliver the payment in coins. So if they're told to pay like 20 billion, they give you quarters.
One company?
Well, we can't pick such allegations.
No, I find it hilarious. I find it hilarious because by the time you're done counting 20 billion in quarters, you're done.
Well, that's where the world has gotten to, and technology is also playing its role. So let's hope for the better.
Well, yeah.
Merci beaucoup, Ismaël.
Thank you so much, Ismaël, for your high-tech chronique.